ఉద్రిక్తతలు తీవ్రస్థాయికి చేరిన వేళ భారత్ అమ్ముల పొదిలో రఫేల్ యుద్ధ విమానాలు చేరాయి. 5 రఫేల్ యుద్ధ విమానాలు వాయుసేనలోకి అధికారికంగా ప్రవేశించాయి. ఆ కార్యక్రమాన్ని ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం ద్వారా చూద్దాం.
From your left this time, the formation will change from India to Diamond. On the leader's command, we will hear, there will be a change. Keep looking. Here comes Sarangs in Diamond formation. An aerial diamond on the occasion of long cherished Indo-French association. Evika M.O. Sarang. Ladies and gentlemen, don't shift your gaze. You are in for a breathtaking surprise. Here goes number 4. That's the captain of Sarang 4, which was pulled up and going for a stall turn. Cats and Nike will join us soon after the short break as they take their short exit. You can wave at them and wish them good luck. And now as we look slightly to the right, Sarang 1, Sarang 2 and Sarang 3 position for the team's signature maneuver, the Dolphins Leap. This maneuver requires a very high degree of skill achieved by strict mind and body coordination. Right in front of you, all three helicopters flying abreast will pull up in the vertical plane and carry out a synchronized stall turn to the left. Like a dolphin in the ocean, Sarangs and Dolphins Leap. And that's number 4 accelerating to join up with the formation. The team performs under the ever watchful eyes of the team's safety officer. Today's safety officer is Squadron Leader Jagan Mohan. Safety Officer 2 is Warrant Officer Rakesh, assisted by the videographers, that is Sergeant Sanjay Koppal Kushwa and LAC Chaudhary. And now as the team prepares for the next maneuver, a word about the maintenance team. It has been led by Wing Commander Himanshu Purohit. He shoulders the onerous responsibility of ensuring that these 4 birds take to the skies and return home safely. Wing Commander Narendra, Squadron Leader Nidhi Sangwan and Squadron Leader Selvin help him in this most demanding task. And as you can see, look straight ahead. The team has rolled in for the next maneuver. We call it the crossover break and we shall listen out for the leader's call. That was crossover break right in front of you, ladies and gentlemen. The team proudly flies the Made in India Advanced Light Helicopter, or Dhruv as we call it. It is an important landmark in the history of Indian aviation industry. Joining the success story of indigenization are the light combat aircraft Tejas, which demonstrated its agility right in front of us just a few minutes back. Time now to brace up for some lower and closer action. The daredevilry of this maneuver is dedicated to the lethal power of the Rafale aircraft. And so, for today's display, we have rechristened the maneuver's name as Rafale Swift. The helicopters are flying at just 50 meters above the ground. Komar with Dhanveer, Ravs with Adi are to your right. Shri with Sneha and Cats with Nike are to your left. From your right and left, ladies and gentlemen. correct. Rafael Swift, right in front of you, ladies and gentlemen, calls for a great round of applause. Every year, a large number of helicopter pilots volunteer to be part of the Sarang team. However, only a few get the opportunity to fly as Sarang pilots. The other pilots of the team are Wing Commander Santosh Kumar Mishra, who is the flight commander of the team, Squadron Leader Gopi Krishna, Squadron Leader J.P. Motsara, Squadron Leader Mukesh, Squadron Leader Manoj and Squadron Leader Mahesh Pundir. Our team boasts of the finest air warriors of the Indian Air Force. An embodiment of the professionalism and ethos of the IAF, the Sarang team has time and again been called to the fore for the humanitarian assistance and disaster relief missions. The team executed these missions with the same finesse with which it has been executing well-choreographed maneuvers in front of you. Integrity and diversity is India's distinction that trickles down to our team as well. Coming from diverse cultural backgrounds, speaking different languages, we all work together towards a common aim of winning hearts and saving lives. On this note, ladies and gentlemen, get set ready. Right in front of you. Team is all set for the grand finale. The Sarang split on the tune of Vande Mataram. The leader will pull up to present a salute to the nation. On the leader's call, the team will get in for Sarang split. A dip and salute by the team leader on behalf of Sarang. Jai Hind and Mehsi.
We now request Air Chief Marshal R. K. S. Bhadauria, Param Vishisht Seva Medal, Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, Vayu Sena Medal ADC to kindly address the gathering.
Her Excellency, Minister for the Army, Honorable Raksha Mantri, Shri Rajnath Singh, Chief of Defence Staff, General Bipin Rawat, distinguished members of the French delegation, dignitaries from the State Government, Ministry of Defence and the Armed Forces, Air Warriors of the Air Force Station Ambala, friends from the media, ladies and gentlemen. It's a matter of great honor for me to welcome this august gathering to the formal induction ceremony of Rafael aircraft. Air Force Station Ambala, while it is the oldest station of the Indian Air Force, it would now be home to the newest aircraft of the IAF inventory. We are adding a new chapter in Ambala's and Indian Air Force's glorious history. By resurrecting the golden arrows at this base, from where they will have the ability to rapidly access our areas of interest. You all have witnessed Rafael aircraft take to the skies and demonstrate some of its maneuvers and agility. The full range of missions and the capability enhancement that this aircraft brings to the Indian Air Force is far more impressive. What we see today is a result of a decisive action by the government to break the impasse in the MMRCA procurement and the prompt action by the Ministry of Defence to acquire 36 aircraft under IGF between the governments. This induction could not have happened at a more opportune time, considering the security scenario today. On behalf of the IAF, I would like to express our deep gratitude to all those who have made this complex acquisition possible and this historic day for the IAF a reality. 17 squadron of Air Force, the Golden Arrows, are singularly blessed to be equipped with this platform. This induction has been indeed unique. After a single hop ferry across 8,300 kilometers after finishing their training from France to Ambala, the first five aircraft landed on 29th of July. And thereafter, the squadron has been really busy and in an overdrive to operationalize. Within this time, they have already flown and familiarized with our operational environment and have undergone intense integrated training with our other combat fleets, including firing of advanced weapons. So this formal induction ceremony today also marks the operational induction of this aircraft into the Indian Air Force. They are good to go and deliver. This timely induction would not have been possible without the active support of the French government, their Air Force and the industry. Despite the severe impact and constraints due to COVID, the industry ensured that the deliveries were not unduly delayed and the training continued. I would like to place on record our deep appreciation for the French Air Force for their support, including the tankers that they provided for a single hop long ferry in order to rapidly ferry the aircraft back home. IAF is specially grateful to Her Excellency, Madame Florence Parly, Minister for the Armed Forces of France, for her unstinted support and for taking out time to be with us here today. Thank you very much. Undoubtedly, this aircraft induction would not only give the Indian Air Force immense op capability, but would become a crucial milestone in the growth of our strategic relationship. To conclude, I would like to thank all the dignitaries and media present here today on this historic occasion. My compliments to the AOC INC Western Air Command, AOC Ambala, and their entire teams. Commanding Officer of the Golden Arrows, Group Captain Harkirat Singh, and his entire team for hard work and professionalism displayed in order to operationalize this aircraft quickly. And this effort needs to continue as we bring in the balanced aircraft and the air crew and ground crew trained on the aircraft. I have no doubt that the aircraft capabilities combined with the commitment and zeal of the Golden Arrows would make a lethal combination, and I expect the Golden Arrows to intimidate and dominate whenever and wherever employed. Jai Hind.
We now request Shri Rajnath Singh, Honorable Raksha Mantri, to kindly address the gathering.
Madam Excellency, French Minister for Armed Forces, Mrs. Florence Parly, Minister of State for Jal Shakti, Sri Ratan Lal Ji Kataria, Home Minister Haryana, our Chief Office Air Staff, Air Chief Marshal R.K.S. Bhadauria, Defence Secretary, Sri Ajay Kumar, Secretary Defence Production, Sri Raj Kumar, Secretary Defence Finance, Mrs. Gargi Kaul, Secretary DIDO, Sri Satish Reddy, Ambassador of France, India, Mr. Emmanuel, French Vice Chief of Air Force, Air General ERC, Atulay, Special Secretary and DG Acquisition, 3, Apurva Chandra, Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanova, retired, distinguished members of the French delegation, senior officers of Armed Forces of India and France, Indian and French friends from media. आज राफेल इंडक्शन सेरेमनी में सर्वप्रथम मैं फ्रांस की ऑनरेबल डिफेंस मिनिस्टर फ्लोरेंस पार्ली का अपनी ओर से और अपनी देशवासियों की तरफ से हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूं। इस इवेंट में आपकी अगस्त प्रेजेंस वर्षों से चली आ रही हमारी मजबूत डिफेंस पार्टनरशिप को दर्शाती है। इंडियन एयरफोर्स में अत्याधुनिक कंबैट एयरक्राफ्ट राफेल के इंडक्शन के अवसर पर आप सभी के बीच आकर मुझे बेहद खुशी यौम ऐतिहासिक क्षण है और हम सब देशवासियों के लिए इस ऐतिहासिक पल का गवाह बनना एक गौरव का विषय है। इस अवसर पर मैं हमारी आर्म फोर्सेस सहित समस्त देशवासियों को हार्दिक बधाई और शुभकामनाएं देता हूं।